Sorting of plastic waste streams by near-infrared spectroscopy. Plastic has been a defining material for our modern society, with the annual production reaching almost 370 million tonnes. However, the widespread use of plastic materials also generates huge volumes of plastic waste, posing severe environmental problems. Therefore, the recycling of plastic is of critical importance to attain a sustainable society. The sorting of plastic waste according to the resin material is a critical step in the recycling process. Plastic materials are categorized by the Resin Identification Coding System, or RIC. Category 1 comprises PET, used for example in drinking bottles. 2, high-density polyethylene for hard bottles. 3, PVC for toys. 4, low-density polyethylene for shampoo bottles. 5, polypropylene for food packaging. 6, polystyrene for yogurt cups. And finally, Category 7 contains other plastics, such as polyurethane, for mattresses. The resin material used in a plastic can also be identified by infrared spectroscopy. This technique works by measuring the absorption of electromagnetic radiation by a molecule containing at least one electric dipole moment with a matching vibration frequency. The vibrations can consist of a change in bond length called stretching, or bond angle called bending. A bond can stretch symmetrically or asymmetrically depending on the molecular structure. A matching vibration frequency allows for energy transfer from the infrared radiation to the molecule, resulting in absorption. Near-infrared reflectance spectroscopy uses electromagnetic radiation with a wavelength between 750 and 2500 nanometers. The absorption of near-infrared is overtones or combinations of the stretching bands which occur in the mid-infrared range between 3300 and 5800 nanometers. The bonds involved are usually those of carbon-hydrogen, nitrogen-hydrogen, or oxygen-hydrogen stretching. Overtones bands in an infrared spectrum are multiples of the fundamental absorption frequency. The energy required for the first overtone is double that of the fundamental absorption energy. The radiation absorbed in the first overtone thus is double the frequency and half of the wavelength. The intensity of radiation reflectance depends on the chemical and physical nature of the plastic material. This technique relies on training a classification rule using a large set of calibration samples in order to identify characteristic reflection signatures, as can be seen here for near-infrared reflection spectra of PET, high-density polyethylene, polypropylene, and polystyrene. Near-infrared reflectance spectroscopy has been integrated into sorting machines designed and manufactured by Redwave. The sorting machines comprise a conveyor belt which moves the shredded plastic along the lighting unit, emitting near-infrared radiation, and the reflection is recorded by a camera. This allows the system to detect the plastic type and eject the plastic scraps with pressurized air into a separate bucket, while the rest passes into another bucket. The machine employed is generally around 3 meters long, with a belt speed of over 3 meters per second, with air pressure above 5 bar. The separation can be performed in various configurations. The near-infrared sensing is generally combined with a color camera and a metal sensor. This system is already employed by Redwave for the sorting of plastic packaging from municipal waste for recycling. The system is also employed in the sorting of PVC from municipal waste for incineration or residue fuel in cement plants. This is crucial because the incineration of PVC results in the production of corrugating hydrogen chloride acid and dioxins. As part of the PUReSMART Horizon 2020 project, Redwave is also developing the sorting of flexible polyurethane foam from end-of-life mattresses for recycling. Thus, near-infrared reflectance spectroscopy has proven to be a powerful tool for the sorting of plastic waste as a critical step in the recycling process.